Hey guys, this is Eskimo Poodle, and we're back. Let's play Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix of Sony PlayStation 4. Last time we actually, you know, were doing anything, we defeated Xemnas for the first time and got ready for the final battle. And then last episode, which we didn't do a whole lot, we read the answer reports, so that was fun. So, in between episodes, I said I was going to do some form leveling, primarily with the final form, and yeah, final form is very close to getting this last level. We just need a couple more points of nobodies, and we're just gonna see how quickly we can grab that, because why not. Let's see here, where is it? I need my paper. Go away. Let's see. I think the last level we got was 73, and we got that one on screen potentially. But if not, if we didn't get it on screen, shield gets negative combo at 73, staff gets air combo boost at 73, and sword gets jackpot at 73. So there we go. And we're not going to get anything again until level 85, and then after that we'll get 99. For our last one. At 85, you're going to get Berserk Charge for the shield. That's the one that lets you do your combos infinitely when you are in MP charge. You get Finishing Plus for Staff, and you'll get Second Chance for Sword. And then at 99, which is your final, I think the final level, you get Thunder Plus for Shield, Drive Converter for Staff, and Critical Half for Sword. So, neato. Let's see. I did a reasonably small chunk of grinding to get the final form stuff. I dealt with the mushroom over in Halloween Town for about 30 minutes and got like 30 drive recovery orbs. Because depending on how good you do, you either get one or two. So it worked out pretty well. And just make sure to use Stitch to keep your mana up. And yeah, you're gonna get it reasonably quick. And then I just started killing stuff over here in the world that never was, in the little staircase right here, because this is where those creeper dudes are. And Frank, or a little further actually. And yeah, these little creeper dudes actually give lots and lots of experience, because there's so many of them. Like, they don't give a whole lot of, like, experience for just killing them. They actually give, like, the basic amount, but still, it's the point that there's going to be a whole lot of them over here. So I said earlier, at the end of last episode, that we were going to go ahead and go do... Ooh, there we go. There's our final level. That was fast. Neat. I said that we were going to go ahead and start doing side quests this episode. Well, I changed my mind. We're going to actually go ahead and beat the game this episode. And then later on in the game, we're going to beat the game again once we get up to having all of our maxed out abilities from pretty much doing everything else. And that'll get us the secret cutscene, so that'll be nice. The main reason I want to do it this way is because this way I can still end up getting the stuff from doing the Mushroom 13 side quest. Because again, you have to beat the game for the last mushroom to show up, and then I think after that you can just re-beat the game eventually and do stuff that way, so it'll work out nice. You guys all die. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and beat the game right now. And then next episode, we'll actually start doing all the side quest stuff. Real fast, though, there was a puzzle piece here that I missed. If you start gliding around over here, it was, like, right in between these two Heartless or Nobody symbols right there. So you had to glide around to get it. So, there you go. Anyways, let's go ahead and beat the game, shall we? Yeah, we'll come back and re-beat the game when we are fully powered up with, you know, doing all the side quests and stuff, and then the poor bastard won't stand a chance. At least this way right here, we might get a small bit of challenge out of it. Oh, by the way, we have Twilight Stones for sale, because I turned in my synthesizing stuff at some point. I think it was most of the stuff from the mushrooms, actually. And, well, we got more stuff to purchase, because we finished the collection, and I guess we can buy Dense Gems, too, so that's nice. Is there anything I care about here? Not in here. Nope. We're still a little ways away from... See, we could make Save the Queen if it told me I could use my damn Serenity Crystal, but I guess because... Wait. Oh, maybe you can't use the, oh, because this is a S rank item. We have to get the Moogle up to level 8 in order to use Serenity Crystals. Okay, in that case, screw it. Can we make anything that has a fair chunk of experience to it? Okay, you have 24. You don't have any bright stones. Okay. Petite ribbons, that'll get 48. And that'll also just give us a pure ribbon, so that'll be nice. Let's do that. There we go. Increases all resistance and extremely increases defense. Fair enough. Ribbon. I guess we can't make this a higher level. Fair enough. But I guess, yeah, let's just go ahead and make a another ribbon there for more experience. Let's see, Garnet Ring. Yeah, a lot of this stuff doesn't actually give that much in the way of experience, sadly. Let's just synthesize whatever we can here. And yeah, once we eventually get up to... The final Moogle rank, yeah, we'll be able to use the half item on that. Actually, we could probably make a couple of you guys, and that'd probably work out pretty well, since that gives the chunk of experience. I don't think we're going to get all of it right here, but we might as well, you know, just keep trying while we keep going. There we go. And I think that's everything right there. Mega potions, we can at least make, yeah, we can make two of you. Why not? Sure, there we go. 12 full experience, why not? And we get a mega ether out of it. So, not too shabby. And drive recovery, we're out. Okay, so we can't make anything else. That's a shame. Yeah, I forgot we needed to get the Moogle up to that last level there. Okay, fair enough. And then you have the... So you have Twilight Stones. Actually, hang on. If I just buy, like... 5 of you. And then, like... 5 of you. And then... A couple of you guys. Yeah, we might actually be able to... Okay, yeah, looks like we can make, because we need mithril shards and... Oh, so this one's going to require Serenity Stone no matter what. I gotcha. Okay, in that case, yeah, just make some mega potions for some quick, easy stuff there. We need mithril shards and... See, we could make, like, 12 of them. And yeah, we just need to get, 24 mithril shards in? That would actually work out reasonably well, I think. Oh, for some reason, I thought we could buy the mithril shards. Is there anything else we can make that we just need to buy? Probably not. Oh, well. We'll get the rest of it later. For now... Go ahead and let's see, we have the ribbon right here, so 4 defense, and then 15 of the other stuff, so that's not too shabby right there. Sardonyx ring, we don't care about you. And I think abilities is gonna say, hey, we got glide. Level 3, which lasts for quite a while, which is fantastic. So that's nice. It actually does run out at some point. At least the level 2 version did for Sora. It lasted like a minute and a half or 2 minutes, but it does run out eventually. Anyways, let's go ahead and get ready to fight Mr. Xemnas. Alright, drive forms are all powered up there. Let's see, Keyblade for Sora. Yeah, I guess we'll stick with Oblivion since that's one of the stronger things we have right now. Oathkeeper. Well, actually, I forgot. We have another form ability. Or another form boost that we can put on for making it so that you're... Oh, I didn't have any of those on. That's why final form was going down so fast. Okay, fair enough. Either way, Let's go fight Xemnas. I'll probably have to mute the final cutscene, but, well, I'll mute one, and then I'll try to keep the other one unmuted and see if it lets me. Let's see. Let's make sure all of our items are set. We got high potions and ethers. That's good. Donald, you're at potions. Goof, you're at high potions. Riku, you're... Honestly, high potions will be fine for you as well. Because Riku will be taking part in the final battle at some point. And by the way, this final battle is multi-stage and drawn out. So, just so you know. Riku, do I care about the rest of your abilities that you don't have equipped? Auto limit and hyper healing? Not particularly. Okay. We are good. Let's go ahead and save. That way I don't got to do that little tiny itsy-bitsy bit of grinding. I think, let me see here. Let's see. I want to say this is roughly where we ended off last episode after I went and saved a Halloween town to get started. And then, yeah, obviously, like, here or here was... Actually, it must have been right here then. Was my save before I recorded the episode where I did all the answer reports. So yeah, it only took about 2 hours of grinding. Wasn't that bad. And a lot of that, like half an hour to 45 minutes, was just me hanging out with the mushroom and just kind of messing around over there. So honestly, not that bad grind-wise. All right, Xemnas, I'm ready. Beyond this door is the beginning of the end of your journey. Are you prepared for what lies ahead? I need a moment to come. Let me actually check my abilities real fast, just to be on the safe side, because there's probably some stuff in here that I'm not going to need, and probably some other stuff that I would care about. Let's see. Combos are good. Let's see. Air combo boost could be nice. Probably not going to use a summon for this fight, so form boost would be good. I could probably turn off the draws for this fight and instead put something else on, but for the most part, we have the vast majority of what we need, I think. I think finishing plus could also be useful, but again, I'm still not entirely sure how that damn thing works. So, air combo boost, that could also be pretty good, so yeah, for now, let's turn off the draws and instead go for the air combo boost. Then we got 2 points if we have anything else we want to put on, I think. Okay. Looks like we are good. Alright, let's go.
Get ready, Xemnas. It all ends here.
Huh?
So, it seems your hearts have led you to obliteration. Perhaps it doesn't pay to be too loyal to one's heart. I will have to be sure and remember that.
No! We can take him on our own.
Okay, I guess I was thinking we might be able to use our, item page, but I guess not. Anyway, this battle has lots of reaction commands, some of which are quite over the edge. So, we're going to see some of those, that's for sure. Like, Sora's going to chop a couple buildings in half with his Keyblade. So, that'd be something to watch out for, because why not? Let's see, can I... that's not what I needed. We need to get to... There you go. Where'd it go? Nope. I missed it. Yeah, with these falling buildings, eventually you're going to do something where you cut them in half and continue on. That'll be... Yeah, there you go. That's what you need to actually get further, surprisingly. You need a skyscraper these things, so you can actually get closer to the big, giant, nobody thing right there. And here, we've got to go ahead and ignore these guys for the most part. And I think we have to... There's something we have to attack here, but I'm not remembering exactly what it is. Oh, I'm trying to remember what we're supposed to kill here. There's something like the cylinders on the right side and left side we gotta kill. There we go. But I'm not entirely sure how we're supposed to do that. I know the stunt dodge helps you get out of the way of the damage there, so that's great. But I don't remember if... Actually, honestly, I think the cylinders might just kind of run out after a while. Try to save your items for later, because again, this is a multi-phase fight, and I don't want to run out. Yeah, it looks like the cylinders are just kind of going down on their own. Alright, stunt dodge out of the way again. I think the main thing here is just avoid the laser beam like two or three times in a row. Yeah, I think we're going to have to avoid it a third time, and then that'll pretty much be the battle, I think. Stunt dodge out of the way. Yeah, we might have to avoid it one more time, because that'll delete the, deplete the left cylinder there. And yeah, I think this first little phase right here should be pretty much over. And then the next couple phases are going to be a bit more gung-ho, that's for sure. There we go. Dodge up here. And we gotta take care of the core, so let's get to it. I think we have to take care of the Heartless before we can actually finish damaging the core here. And you might still get a couple levels while you're in here. It's possible. I'm pretty sure you do get an ability or some other something or other for actually defeating the boss. And it'll save, so that'll be nice. Ooh, that's a nice finisher right there. That did a lot of health, or a lot of damage. Alright, get rid of you bastards. I think I might still have Donner to Goofy set to not do anything right now. Except for just, you know, heal me, which is kind of fine. Come on, attack. Heal save. I think it just kills him nice and fast right there, so that's a nice little man. Alright, barrier has been unlocked. Let's go. And there we go. Energy core has been stopped. Let's proceed forward. It kind of looks like a... The fuel pack of like a space shuttle or something right there. Does he have a crown? I think he has a couple crowns. What is up with the final bosses of Kingdom Hearts turning into a giant, like, ship thing? Oh, looks like he's using a Zeldin's spear right there. It's kind of cool, I guess. You doing okay there, champ? Xemnas, you're kind of not putting up much of a fight. Okay, I think right here we're going to have to... Okay, it looks like he's using a... Gimmicks water things, so that's cool. So you guys all die. Here, about dance. Yeah, so I think his gimmick here is he's using abilities of some of the other organization members. I don't know how many other he uses, but well, we at least saw Zeldin's and Gimmicks's, so that was pretty cool. Very easy though. So far.
I need more rage. I need more hearts.
Xemnas, there's more to a heart than just anger or hate. It's full of all kinds of feelings. Don't you remember?
Unfortunately, I don't.
Gosh, you all did great.
You're coming back with us, right?
I had given in to the darkness.
Riku!
How am I gonna face everyone?
Like this?
Hurry!
I'll open a path.
You don't belong in the Dark Realm anymore, Riku.
How do we get out of here, Your Majesty? Who did this?
Well, I'm not sure. But we better hurry and get through.
Wait for me!
Come on!
Thank you, Naminé. Sure. See? We meet again, like we promised.
Huh? You said we'd meet again. But when we did, we might not recognize each other.
I did, didn't I?
But I knew you.
It's strange.
I think I understand. I see myself the way you remember me. And you see yourself the way I remember you.
I always thought nobodies were doomed to fade back into darkness.
Yeah. But you and I didn't. We got to meet our original selves.
So, we can be together again.
Right. Anytime Sora and Kairi are together.
We'll be together every day. Right, Sora?
Yeah.
Look sharp.
Don't worry. You're all still you.
Hey, let's go home.
Riku, come on.
Yeah.
Sora, Riku!
What?
Sora!
Yeah, Xemnas got a giant dragon nobody ship. Pretty cool. Okay. So for this battle, you're just gonna want to spam square whenever the lasers come up to you, and if any heartless or nobody's come up to you, you want to try to attack them with your keyblade here, and eventually you'll have a nice fat energy bar up at the top left that you can go ahead and use to fire at the big old dragoon thing, and it will do damage. And that'll be nice. Let's see. But I gotta see, I think Roxas gets the better deal with Nominee, because, yeah, she's just a lot better looking, in my opinion. I don't know. Maybe I just like Vaughn better, but she's just a lot cuter, I think. That's my opinion, at least, and I'm sticking to it. Plus, she just has a nice, simple design, so it does look nice, especially compared to everybody else in the series, which has about a billion zippers per square inch. Which kind of gets old after a while, but yeah, use up your laser right. Once you get your bar full, you'll do some damage to the dude, and eventually we'll get closer, and we'll be able to actually attack it again. Yeah, so this part of the battle, you just gotta kind of stick around for a little while. I don't think we can absorb these lasers, but we can go ahead and kill these guys. Yeah, kind of a weird final boss, but again, we still have like another form or two here, so we're not done yet. Don't you worry about that. We're gonna have an actual battle against Xemnas again, so don't be too worried about missing out on too much here. All right, we got enough for our mega laser. Nice. I think you can just shoot off your regular laser when you have a little bit of energy, and it'll do like small amounts of damage to like the nobodies or whatever. But frankly, it's not really necessary. Just save up for your big laser and go from there. Alright, so eventually we're going to try to shoot off the wings here, and that'll work out pretty well for us. I guess we're taking some damage from that, which I didn't think we were going to, but okay. Got it. Yeah, if we use our regular laser... Oh, I guess it doesn't actually drain... I guess it doesn't actually drain our laser meter. Okay, neat. But we do have to have some energy in there. If somebody had told you when you started Kingdom Hearts that your final battle was going to be on a space motorcycle and it was against a giant dragon thing, you would have kicked them out of your house as being lunatic. And yet, they were completely right. So, I don't know what they were on when they made this boss form, but it must have been some good shit. Must have been some good shit. Those. And let's go ahead and laser, since honestly the laser's working out pretty well. And if we knock the little dudes into the ship, we can get some damage out of this. That's nice. Yeah, knocking the little dudes into the ship does damage the boss there. It's not perfect, but it helps. Come on, give me some more actual like lasers that I can absorb. Yeah, I don't think your little laser attack with the square button actually makes it so you can damage the dude. That has to be the big mega ultra laser thing that you got going on. Come on, give me more lasers. There you go. I'm gonna keep knocking you guys into the there we go. Keep knocking you guys into there, and it'll work out eventually. There we go. I think now that's the end of that. And I think now we're going to have actual Xemnas fight. Potentially. With just me and my good buddy Riku. Okay, now I think after this phase is the actual Xemnas fight. This is kind of like a repeat mixture of the fight that we had where the skyscrapers, and then also the fight that was like this with Donald and Goofy that we had.
Hey, Riku?
Yeah?
I wanted to thank Naminé, but I couldn't bring myself to say it. Not until everything was back to the way it was before.
Don't worry. We'll make that happen. Once this is over, you can thank her all you want.
Yeah!
Try not to get hit by that too much, because that'll cause a couple problems there. But yeah, for this phase, eventually he's going to knock you, like, out into the, he's going to, like, knock you out into the, like, the space area, and you're going to have to, like, take care of a couple of buildings to get back over here and stuff. It's kind of weird. For the most part, shouldn't cause too many problems. Dark Aura. Yeah, see, like, right there. That'll we have to go glide back pretty much, I think. And then also, I think there's a couple like skyscrapers that we have to deal with to get over there as well.
Are you certain you can trust me?
Come on. I thought there was a couple like skyscrapers we had to like attack to get back over there, but I could be. Yeah, there's like skyscrapers somewhere we have to deal with. But I don't know where. Ah, here we go. I think this right here will do it. Yeah, here we go. There's like very specific ones you gotta find in order to actually get back here. And cut in half to break his little shield so we can actually get back there and attack the little bastard. And use Riku's dark shield to try to avoid some of the damage there. And eventually we'll get back to the battle here. Yeah, hopefully it doesn't knock us into outer space too many times, because that'd be kind of irritating. He's pretty easy in this particular phase. I think the final phase, he actually does have a couple phases that I'm not terribly fond of, but for the most part, we should be okay. Yeah, so let's just try to get a little closer here. Let's try this right here. This might be perfect. There you go. And don't forget your second reaction command there, Meteor Rain, to actually break the shield and get closer. Now, hopefully he doesn't knock us back into space here, because trying to re-glide back over would be kind of a pain. I wonder if you just get the glide ability for this fight if you didn't unlock Final Form for whatever reason. Like, if you just kept coming over here without actually unlocking it, would you just, like, be granted it for the fight right here? Probably.
Heroes from the realm of light, I will not allow it to end this way. Not yet. If light and darkness are eternal, then surely we nothings must be the same. Eternal.
You're right. Light and darkness are eternal. Nothing probably goes on forever, too. But guess what, Xemnas?
That doesn't mean you're eternal.
No more eternal than that radiance of yours. Anger and hate are supreme. We shall go together.
His cloak is so cool. I like it. It's like It's like white with the. Come on, can I heal here? No. Alright, block. See if I can get my heal off. There we go. Yeah, his cloak is so cool with the crap. I just like his cloak. It's like white with the black nobody symbols. There we go. That's what I'm trying to say. You kick my ass. Yeah, I remember this part of the fight actually being hard compared to, you know, the rest of it. Okay. Come on. I think we're both using healing at the wrong time there. Come on. Eventually we're gonna be like taken hostage by Xemnas here. And we're gonna have to do some cool stuff here. Also, I think I keep losing the lockdown. So yeah, Xemnas definitely has some weird tricks up his sleeve. It's definitely kind of a pain to deal with. But I think we'll survive. Yeah, make sure to use Riku's Dark Shield ability, and Dark Aura, because the Dark Shield will help you mitigate damage that, you know, I'm taking all over the place, and Dark Aura will get in a little bit of extra damage as well. Okay, yeah, so now, okay, that's not what I was thinking. I was thinking that's when we would get caught by, Xemnas, but I guess not, but yeah, just keep reversing right here. Yeah, just keep spamming your reversal right here, and eventually you'll get out of that. Oh yeah, dude. There you are. Get out of the way. Lose. And start damaging again. Oh, that hurts. There you go. Get back to damaging here. He's not doing his thing that he's supposed to be doing here with the like holding Sora hostage thing that I'm trying to remember. But I know he did. I don't see him doing it for whatever reason. Oh, okay. High potion was used for Riku. Good man. I'm proud of you. Okay, right here. This right here, I think he did. So he knocks Riku away.
Sora.
And then we gotta go ahead and try to get closer here. Try to use Dark... I think you just wanna take a few steps, use Dark Aura. Take a few steps, use Dark Aura. Your goal is to get over to Sora over here. And the floor is kinda weird, but you know, you'll get it eventually. Alright, Riku, come on, buddy. You're killing me. Okay, Riku died, so I think that might be me having to redo the fight.
Anger and hate.
Okay, good. I was about to say, please don't make me redo the whole thing, because that would suck. Also, how many, okay, we're still good on our... Still good on our potions, and this time I might do less, you know, taking damage from some of the attacks here, so that'd be nice. Or not, okay. Fucking A, dude. I thought he was done with his attack, so I stopped mashing the reaction command, and he took advantage of that and reamed me. Yeah, Xemnas definitely puts up a fight. Granted, some of the fight that he puts up is kind of cheap, but it's a fight nonetheless. I was so mad in the first time I played the game, and I was like, how come he gets lightsabers and I just get a keyblade? I mean, don't get me wrong, Keyblade's cool, but, you know, lightsaber, man. Lightsaber. This is it. Everybody wants a lightsaber. Oh, I was trying to reverse a lot of that, but apparently it was not necessary, so good enough. Die. Okay. The way he teleports around, he loses your lock-on. Not my favorite thing ever, but a lot of bosses in this game do that. And also, I still don't know how to change lock-on targets, so you know there's that. Okay, I managed to avoid that little bit of damage. That's nice. We're definitely doing better on damage right now, I think, than we did previously, so that's nice. And he's not actually taking that much damage to take down. So we're doing pretty solid here. Try to ignore these as much as possible. I don't know. I don't think these little lasers will actually do any damage to Xemnas there. So, like the little the reflective spam that we normally do, I don't think that does anything to Xemnas. It'd be nice if it did, but I don't think it does. Oh yeah. There you go. Yeah, I think we both managed to use our high potion that time, so that's fantastic. Stop teleporting. There you go. I don't think you're the right Xemnas. Yeah, you're the right Xemnas. And there we go. Now we gotta survive with Mr. Riku here. So again, attack the clone with Dark Aura, and do your best to get over to Sora, and try to figure out where you're going on this weird little dimension floor thingy, which frankly I'm not a big fan of, but whatever. I don't know if I'm making any progress or if I'm just getting pushed back here. Stop pushing me away. Sora's friend, stop pushing me away. Go ahead. Hey, we can't use any potions to... Okay, I am like right there. Come on. There you go. Rescue Sora. We are back in action. As soon as we get Sora back, I'm popping a heal. I think we might need a reaction command here. Nope, okay. There we go. Okay, we can actually attack Xemnas now. Nice. Yeah, that little thing where Sora's kidnapped is kind of cool, but at the same time, the weird like floor where you can't see what's going on is also not the best thing ever. This part right here is super easy because all you're doing is spam the triangle for 30 seconds until, you know, they decide to stop the reversal stuff. There we go, dude. Wow, you're close. Oh, come on, I was trying to... I think for this final bit right here, you can't kill him normally. You have to do this reaction command and be prepared to mash triangle and deflect, or triangle and X to do this really, what I thought was really cool when I was a kid, because, you know, you're just reflecting 1,000 freaking lasers, and the way your keyblades, like, flash as you're moving around, it looks like you were moving so much faster than you were trying to deflect all these billion lasers that they were throwing at you. It was so cool. I mean, it still is pretty cool. It's definitely some spectacle right here, that's for sure. And there we go. And that should be it, I think. And there we go.
Keyblade.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be too sure of that. Sora. I can't.
Don't say another word. It's not over. It's just not.
How can you say that? Even if we could go on. Look where we are.
Aw, come on, Riku. You've been hanging out in darkness too long. You gotta try and think positive.
Sora?
Hmm?
You lead.
Got it.
You know, I always figured I was better at stuff than you.
Really? Hmm.
Are you mad?
No. I kinda always thought you were better at everything, too. Riku, look. What's that light?
End of the road.
Yep.
Put me down. I can walk.
You know, maybe the darkness has gotten to me too. Riku!
This world is perfect for me. If this is what the world really is, just this, then maybe I should fade back into darkness.
Riku!
If the world is made of light and darkness, we'll be the darkness.
Yeah. The other side. The Realm of Light is safe now. Kairi, the King, and the others are there.
That's what I mean. Hey, Sora. Could you help me? I want to get down to the water. At least the waves sound the same. What I said back there, about thinking I was better at stuff than you?
Mm-hmm.
To tell you the truth, Sora, I was jealous of you.
What for?
I wished I could live life the way you do. Just following my heart.
Yeah, well, I've got my share of problems, too.
Like what?
Like wanting to be like you.
Hmm. Well, there is one advantage to being me. Something you can never imitate.
Really? What's that?
Having you for a friend.
Then I guess I'm okay the way I am. I've got something you could never imitate, too.
Sora?
Hmm?
I think it's for you.
Thinking of you wherever you are. We pray for our sorrows to end, and hope that our hearts will blend.
Now I will step forward to realize this wish. And who knows? Starting a new journey may not be so hard. Or maybe it's already begun. There are many worlds, but they share the same sky. One sky, one destiny.
Light.
The door to light.
We'll go together.
Yeah.
Back.
Means you're home.
And you and I, there's a new land. A sanctuary, my sanctuary.
So, I've been talking this entire time, and I didn't realize my microphone was off. So, we're just going to go ahead and start from here. So, that's good stuff. Just pretend like I was letting you guys watch all the fancy cutscenes up until here. So, oops. I was trying to say before I realized that my microphone was off that Ariel is actually the only Disney princess to actually have a kid. All the other Disney princesses, yeah, they might get married or whatever, but none of them have ever actually had a kid in canon, as far as I know. I mean, yeah, technically Nala has, but she's not a Disney princess. She's a lion. So, none of the other Disney princesses ever bothered to pop any kids out. I might still have to mute part of the ending just to be on the safe side, but I don't think it'll matter too much. Oh well. We didn't miss too much of me saying anything important, so I'm basically saving my little mini-review for the end of all the little scenes here. Heck, we might just do our little mini-review on the title screen or something like that. Is this supposed to say black for like a while here or what? This would be hilarious if they're like, yeah, this is the fate of the nobodies right here. It's just a screen of blackness. That'd be kind of freaking hilarious. But I guess that was the end, so oh well. I'll put a note in there saying, hey, go to the end to hear me start talking here. But I'm going to be quiet here now because there's other stuff to be quiet about. Like this.
Nothing's changed, huh?
Nope. Nothing will.
What a small world.
But part of one that's much bigger.
Yeah.
Hey, Riku. What do you think it was? The door to the light.
This.
This?
Yeah. It's always closer than you think.
Sora! Riku!
Hey, what's up?
Look.
From the king?
Ooh, ambitious adventurer. We got something there. What did we get? We got, you just show me what it is, damn it. Clear the game and watch the ending sequence. Okay. And clear the game on a higher difficulty level. Fantastic. Yeah, I don't think we got the secret ending. I think that might have been the secret ending in the original version of the game, but in this version, there's another secret ending where you have to do a whole bunch of crap of Jiminy's Journal. You got to get it to 100%, and then you can go ahead and get the secret ending. And, apparently I used Anti-Form a fair amount of time, and I used Valor Form a whole bunch, which, frankly, I am fine with, because I like Valor Form. Valor Form had the ability to end your combo at any time, which was fantastic. And apparently I healed Donald Goofy a lot, so... I wonder if that counts for healing yourself as well. Yeah, there we go. We are finished with Kingdom Hearts 2, except for all the side stuff that we're going to be taking our time doing. Because, well, some of these battles that are going to come up are pain in the ass. Plus, we got to do a whole lot of grinding and some of the other stuff like that. So, that's going to be fun. But yeah, I remember when this game first came out, I was really excited for it. Because... I mean, after finishing Kingdom Hearts 1, they had set up a sequel, like, fucking perfectly with the Another Side, another story with the Roxas versus Riku battle that you didn't know who they were at the time. And so I knew there was going to be a number 2. And then Chain of Memories came out on the Game Boy Advance, and I played the shit out of that, except I never beat Roxas or Riku's story on there for some reason. I beat the actual main game, but I never touched the... Riku side. And I think I got mad because, you know, Riku has his own preset decks, and some of those were a pain in the ass. So, and then Kingdom Hearts 2 came out, and I was just the happiest little poodle ever. Granted, I don't think I was a poodle at that time, but, you know, still. But it was freaking fantastic. It had everything from the first game with a couple changes, and some of those changes I didn't really care for. Like, I really still do miss, like, the Dalmatian collectibles, the Trinities on the ground, tech points. Those are the three things that I really missed the most, I think. And also, I wish they had done a bit more with the keyhole sequences in the game instead of just copying and pasting the same thing 13 or 14 times or whatever, but oh well. But, yeah. But yeah, everything else in the game, they did a pretty damn good job with. I remember originally I did not like the new magic system because of the way you had to wait for like 45 seconds to use magic after casting Cure. And so I was real mad about that because I was just used to spamming Cure in Kingdom Hearts 1 because, well, you needed to for some of those bosses. Eventually I grew to like it. I don't think in the original version of the game I used Reflect like at all. I think I saw it, and I was like, oh, this thing only lasts like half a second, this thing useless, and I just basically never touched it ever. I'm realizing now that Kingdom Hearts 2 Vanilla doesn't have that much in the way of side quests. Like, you don't have the Mushroom 13, you don't have the Absent Silhouettes, you don't have the puzzle pieces, you have, like, the Atlantica stuff, you have the Winnie the Pooh stuff, you have the Gummy Ship stuff, and then the Colosseum stuff. Yeah, you didn't have any extra... a lot of the other stuff, like the extra battles and whatnot. And I don't think there was, like, a secret boss besides, like, Sephiroth, obviously, because, spoiler alert, Sephiroth's the secret boss again. Yeah, I love this game. There's a couple times the combat just gets kind of, but for the most part, the additions to the combat are nice with all the extra combos you can do in the air and stuff. I remember when I saw that you could use the negative combo to reduce your combo to just being the combo finisher itself. I was like, oh, this is freaking sweet, and I tried it, and it was cool, but I don't think I had the right setup for it, and I was doing, like, no damage, so I immediately went back to, like, an 8-hit combo, and I was like, okay, this is much better. Also, I was really mad that you didn't keep your Keyblades from the first game, because, well, you had a whole bunch of really cool Keyblades, and they were just gone. So, oh well. Granted, I do like a lot of the Keyblades that came out here in Kingdom Hearts 2. Some of them less so than others, but for the most part, they're pretty cool. I think Kingdom Hearts 1 has some of my favorite Keyblades, and Birth by Sleep, which the ending right there was showing, has some of my other favorite Keyblades in it from the games that I played. 358 over 2 days, not so much. By the way, With that ending right there, the Birth by Sleep cutscene, that's not actually the next game in the series. 358 over 2 days is the next game in the series, which will be the next one we're playing or watching or however we do it. So, I think people were expecting Birth by Sleep to come out, and then you had that 358 over 2 days for the DS, and it was cool, but there was also some weirdness to it for some of the choices they did there, but we'll get to that when we get to it. By the way, I think I've only played that one for like a couple hours, and there was a reason for that, I think, but we'll get to that eventually. But yeah, Kingdom Hearts 2, they improved the combat, they improved slash muddled up the story a bit. You had a... I really liked how you went back to the worlds you went to before, and they were familiar, but at the same time, different. They had their new stories or whatever. I feel like they could have had a couple more worlds in here that weren't returns, because I think like half the worlds were returning from Kingdom Hearts 1. But then you had the surprise worlds like surprise worlds like Tron and Timeless River that I don't think anybody was freaking expecting unless they were spoiled in a magazine at some point, because hey, back in 2001 or 2002, that's how you got your video game news. They came out in freaking magazines and you were like, oh, so here's a screenshot for the game. You didn't have everything spoiled for you, you know, half a month or so before the game came out. But yeah, it had a lot of cool worlds. Like I really liked Beast Castle, because for the most part, you basically considered Hollow Bastion as Beast Castle in Kingdom Hearts 1, even though it wasn't. And I like how they redid the summons in the game, or from the first game, to be worlds in this game. Granted, you didn't get to go to Dumbo's World, and I don't think you get to go to Dumbo's World until Dream Drop Distance, which is still several games away. And I think that's the only time you go to their world. Actually, for the summons, now that I'm thinking about it, except for Peter Pan, who was a summon in this game, which I don't know if we actually used, you don't go to the summons worlds. Well, and I guess that genie, you don't go to the summons worlds more than like once or twice. So like, I don't think you ever go back to the Lion King world. I don't think you ever go back to Land of Dragons. I don't think you ever go to the Dumbo world more than once. Bambi, I don't think you ever go to his world, ever. Let's see. Chicken Little, I don't think you go to his world either. No, I'm thinking about it. Stitch, you actually do have a space-themed version of his world. Granted, it's not the Hawaii version, which would be really cool with all the extra experiments running around. That'd be a really cool world, a Lilo and Stitch world with a bunch of the stronger experiments as bosses. That'd be awesome. I used to love that TV show. That show was great. And the movie was also really cool, too. But I liked the show because it really expanded on all the monsters. And yeah, a lot of the monsters were kind of, you know, crappy, but some of them were actually pretty cool. Like, there was a... Yeah, there was a couple. I won't spoil them for you in case you haven't watched the show, but there was a lot of good stuff there. But yeah, Kingdom Hearts 2, great freaking game. I really like the opening sequence, the Sanctuary song here. Freaking beautiful. Plus, the opening animation for it was freaking great. I love the scene where she draws the stairs, and then it like transitions into them running up the stairs. That's awesome. I love it. And also where Sora starts fighting Marluxia in Castle Oblivion, and it switches every attack or so to Riku fighting Ansem. It was so cool. I love it. But yeah, we are finished with Kingdom Hearts. We will be redoing the final boss at some point in the future after we pimp out our Sora all the way and get the journal to 100% and all that good stuff so we can see the final secret ending, and also so we can, just destroy young Mr. Oh, I guess we have a cutscene mode. So that way we can just destroy young Mr. Xemnas there. But until then, we got a lot of stuff to do. We've got... We've got to collect synthesis stuff. We've got to take care of the mushrooms, which I feel like they should be... Every entry in Jiminy's journal has been unlocked. Continue the adventure to define the question marked entries. New enemy has materialized and awaits Sora in one of the worlds. I don't know where that guy's at, but I know he's around somewhere. Yeah, we got the mushrooms, we got Colosseum stuff to do. There's not just one Colosseum cup left. There's actually several Colosseum cups left, and we'll see about those when we get... Actually, for the most part, though, they're kind of like rehashes of the old cups, so it's not that exciting now that I'm thinking about it. Then we got a couple more Organization 13 members to battle, and then after we do those, we got even more Organization 13 people to battle, so... Not going to spoil a whole lot there, but we'll see. But yeah, next episode, we'll go ahead and start with... I think next episode will take it easy and just start with collecting all the puzzle pieces that we can find. And I think we'll spend some time doing that. And then after that, we'll start working on the mushrooms and synthesizing and other stuff like that. So, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Have a good one.